On this weekend and now well into next week with all of the fire danger, and Darren Peck is here with the latest.
Yeah, and for anybody who hasn't had a chance to get up into the hills yet, if you don't live with easy access to them, you haven't seen them, I'm going to use the access that we've got to a network of cameras across the whole Bay Area to show you what it looks like, and I'm going to spotlight the Diablo Range. There's a peak up there called Gregor Peak, which actually looks out over towards the Delta. That's Pittsburgh and Antioch out there in the distance. You can see the water of the Delta and the wind farms out by Rio Vista if you've got good eyes. But I want you to see the hills and how brown they've already gotten. This is the Diablo Range that would sit just up behind those two communities. Now I'm going to take you over into the East Bay Hills to Briona's Regional Park, and you can see it's just as brown here. And there's a way to measure this, and it's important to this story. The number one reason why we're dealing with red flag warnings in May is not solely because we've got this offshore wind event. If this was a typical year, we would not be looking at fire weather concerns right now. But here's how untypical this year is. We're going to gauge something called the energy release component in the grasses, twigs, and trees. That's a measurement of how much energy is stored in those fuels should a fire get started. You can track it throughout the course of the year. There's a scale over here that goes from 0 to 100, but that's just to give us some perspective. Look what average is. By the time we get into August, but really September, right there, that was the heart of what we used to think of as traditional fire season. And that's when the energy release component in those fuels is on average the highest. These records go back 30 years. We can see what the records have been. What's the highest this value has ever gotten? And you can just watch the wavy line there. But what really matters is where we are today. And if we look at 2021 so far, it's a squiggly line, because this will vary wildly depending on if you get a little bit of rain that wets the landscape, the reading will go way down, which is what we like. And if you haven't gotten any rain in a while and the temperatures go up, and by the way, it is the temperatures, the warm atmosphere pulling the moisture out of these grasses, twigs, that's a primary driver to all this. We've been well above average for much of the spring. Look where the line is. It's above the record value. In other words, this important measurement of how vulnerable the landscape is to a fire right now is the highest it's been since we started keeping records on this stuff 30 years ago. This is specific to the Diablo Range. But I think what stands out more than just looking at the records is to take that line here for early May and bring it across here towards September. And you can see we are right now where we would typically have been by September. So the landscape is already as dry as it would be within the heart of what we used to think of as fire season. This image, more than any other, perhaps helps drive the point home of how our fire season has changed. So that's one takeaway. We're still in the red flag warning. The map hasn't changed, but the timing has. This was set to expire tomorrow at 6 in the morning. Now the National Weather Service has extended it until Tuesday at 6 p.m. And yes, North Bay Mountains still have to be on guard for this, as do the East Bay Hills and the valleys through inland Contra Costa County. And another way to look at it, instead of the red flag warning, is to see where the greatest area of concern is. Not that this should lessen our preparedness to any degree. If you've got a red flag warning, the National Weather Service takes issuing that very seriously, and they do it because they think we all need to be paying attention. But there's a higher degree of concern with this particular offshore wind event over in the Central Valley. So